Welcome back to the Making Madness YouTube channel. This is Jonathan here to break down the news as Jason Preston has announced that he is forgoing his remaining college eligibility and he is going to turn professional. He is not going to play at Ohio. Kind of a bummer for Ohio and the MAC in general. This was kind of a team that, you know, last season was obviously a success. They were 12 seed. They beat Virginia in the first round and made it to round 32 before ultimately losing. But, you know, this is Ohio team that coming into the season with Preston, you know, potentially back, they were going to be a, you know, team to look out for, obviously, in the MAC and college basketball. They could have been, you know, theoretically speaking, you know, 2019 Buffalo is kind of a team I'm kind of reminded of. That Buffalo team, they obviously, you know, beat Arizona and then returned basically everyone and then ended up being a 6 seed, lost in the round of 32, but they were, you know, 6 seed from the MAC. That's some type of talent. So it's a slight bit of a bummer, but, you know, we'll move on. Speaking of Buffalo, they probably become now the favorites in the MAC. I still think Ohio has a good chance, but, you know, Buffalo has a really good team coming back. Jonathan Williams, one of the main pieces, he might be, you know, heading into next season the conference player of the year. It might be Mark Sears, who at Ohio was kind of, you know, the number two option for Ohio this past season. Obviously, with Jason Preston being the number one option, Mark Sears will step in and be the starting point guard for this team. And then, you know, they can just kind of fill this roster out. They have Bennett Vanderplas. He's a 6'8 forward. He's going to probably start at the power forward spot. They've got Jason Carter. That's going to be a good front court. They've got Ben Roderick. They have some good guards, Ludin McDay, Miles Brown, Michael Brown Jr. They're going to, you know, be asked to take a little bit of a bigger role. Mark Sears is obviously going to take a bigger role. They also have Sam Towns, Colin Granger, Dwight Wilson also returning pieces. And then they have two recruits, A.J. Clayton and I.J. Azuma, two-star recruits, so we'll kind of wait and see what they do. But, you know, for this Ohio team, I think, you know, you can still reasonably have them as the favorite in the MAC heading into next season. I would say my pick might at this point be Buffalo, but it's a pretty close race between the two. Certainly the MAC is going to be good, but kind of the one area of somewhat frustration is they don't have a, you know, 2019 Buffalo type team that, you know, is a legit, like, at large team. They don't have that this year, but it's still going to be a fun conference. It's still going to be good. It might even be more highly competitive because Jason Preston heads out to the NBA. And as for Jason Preston as well, he's someone I think he will, you know, find his way into an NBA system. He's probably going to play, you know, early on in the G League, but he's someone that we've seen, you know, develop throughout time. He's, you know, someone that, you know, a few years ago, no one even knew his name, and he was lucky to just get a scholarship to Ohio. And now here he is, you know, heading to the NBA draft because he blew up and became really good. So I would not doubt this player. He's someone that I think at some point probably makes an NBA roster, probably is playing NBA basketball, whether it's next year, whether it's 3 years down the line. I believe he will be in the NBA. Thanks again for tuning in to Making the Madness on YouTube. We'll be back with more.